it's not only the individual chemicals that more often than not have not been really tested. We talk often about that chemical soup or that cocktail that's in the body. There's no question that that combination has never been tested to see what's that impact to human health on human health.
That's right. There's only a few where we've looked at what we could call the joint effects or the synergistic effects, where, for example, like with tobacco and lead, both of those are risk factors for ADHD. And if a child is prenatally exposed to tobacco, for example, they're 2 to 2.5 times more likely to develop ADHD. If a child is exposed to higher levels of lead during childhood, they're also at about 2 to 2.5 times more likely to develop ADHD. But those children that are exposed to both, they're over 8 times more likely. So those two toxic chemicals acting together can magnify the impact of each other. So kids with high exposures to both of those, 1 in 4 of those children met criteria for ADHD. And to give you an impact of what that means on a national scale, we found that 1 out of 3 kids who have ADHD in the United States had ADHD because of exposures to one or the other or both of those toxic chemicals. Now, if you can imagine for a moment, if I developed a vaccine or a drug that could prevent 1 out of 3 cases of ADHD, I'd be a multimillionaire. We got a little bit of scholarly attention, but not much more. And so the way we treat these toxic chemicals in terms of taking action, developing legislation, investing to protect children is by far quite trivial compared to many other diseases. And the problem is, while the social benefits are huge, if we would actually act and reduce these exposures, it's hard to privatize those benefits. Right. And since the health system, or the medical system, I should say, because it really isn't a health system in the United States, the medical system is set up based on the free market. Nobody acts, including our government, until there's a way to profit from it, until there's a way to privatize those benefits.
Right. Totally agree with you, and certainly an ongoing argument. And you know, I was doing the math as you were talking, it's essentially what we're saying is that 2 plus 2 does not equal 4. When you're talking about this chemical experiment that we're undergoing, 2 plus 2 equals 8, and it may even equal 10 or 12 down the road.
Absolutely. And we have a number of examples like that. If you're exposed to both arsenic and tobacco, your risk of developing cancer over years can be as high as 25 times. Now, this is not a new concept. Rachel Carson talked about this and so many other things 60 years ago when she published her book, Silent Spring. And many of the things that she said then were really prophetic. We've learned that what she said and what was dismissed by so many scientists of her day were accurate, were right on target.
Right. Yeah, if you haven't had a chance to read Rachel Carson's book, there's actually also a documentary on her. It's extraordinary what she faced and how she stood up and was probably one of the first key people to make us aware and more conscious of these issues. So definitely a leading figure there.
Yeah.